Let's talk about the radiographic diagnosis. When we need to understand the clinical diagnosis, we have to confirm it with the help of a radiographic diagnosis. There are various radiographs. Most commonly, this is the plain film radiography, and other is a CT scan radiography. When we talk of plain film radiography, it is a Waters view, then it is a submental vertex view, and third is the Cardwell's view, which is caudally angled posterior anterior radiograph of the skull designed to better visualize the paranasal sinuses. Here, this presentation is of a Waters view, where we can easily see the zygomatic bone. The black arrows are indicative of the fracture area, the frontozygomatic suture. Here, then there is the infobetal rim region, and the third fracture, which is easily evident, is the zygomaticomaxillary buttress region. This is the Waters view. In the same view, there's another thing which is very important. Here, there's presence of a transosseous wire has been placed. It might be a prior case of zygomatic fracture of this a region in this patient, right? What is submental vertex view? It's also known as a jug handle view. It is a very good view to assess the zygomatic arches. And lastly, the CT scans. The CT scans are important because they give us a slice to slice sections of the fracture areas, so that we can easily interpret what is the level of fracture and what else has been fractured. For suppose we are able to see, yes, the orbital floor is fractured here, the area is filled with the blood, and even the nasal cavity is also filled with the blood. It is not the blood is visible, it is the haziness which is trying to be correlated with the haziness on the other side. Here the sinuses are clear, there is no haziness in the nasal cavity, and the orbital floor is intact. So we are trying to see the haziness as well as the fracture areas or the bones which have been shattered. Again, radiographic diagnosis, this is a CT scan. Here we can easily assemble it that yes, there is no fracture on this side, but yes, there is a discrepancy or discontinuity of the bone into the frontozygomatic suture, as well as discontinuity in the infobetal region, which may be suggestive of fracture of the zygomatic bone. If we try to see from this view, yes, there is some kind of displacement of the bone. That means the bone in this area is depressed as compared to this area. We are able to see, yes, this part of the sinuses is already occluded with the blood. That is presence of haziness. Again, the same thing, presence of haziness into this A region of the sinuses as compared to these sinuses. And even this is the wall of the zygomatic bone is fractured here, right? So we are able to ascertain this presence of fracture on the right side of the patient, that is the zygomatic complex fracture is present. The other radiographs, similar radiographs, again the same thing, we are talking again and again to you. This is the CT scan image, this is the Waters view image, and this is the submental vertex. Here we are able to appreciate the zygomatic arch, but here the zygomatic arch is slightly bent inside. That means it may suggest of fracture of the zygomatic arch. That is includes the radiographic diagnosis after establishing a clinical diagnosis. This completes the part one of the zygomatic fracture topic. Next, in the next topic, we are going to talk to you regarding the management part of the zygomatic complex fractures. Thank you.